SpaceX is busy preparing for the orbital launch debut, its next-generation Starship rocket. The FAA notice said the SpaceX launch's primary expected date is April 10, but listed backup dates as April 11 and 12. A key SpaceX Starship Super Heavy rocket launch test could happen next week, according to a planning notice posted Tuesday by the Federal Aviation Administration. The FAA notice said the launch's primary expected date is April 10, but listed backup dates as April 11 and 12. Billionaire Elon Musk, SpaceX rocket and satellite company must still get a launch license for what is expected to be its first orbital flight test from Boca Chica, Texas. For what it's worth, a flight restriction for April 10 through 12 was published in the last hour for the Starship test flight. This is a piece of evidence that goes against recent signs of a slip. A NOTAM has been posted for Mexican airspace to warn aviators of the launch of Starship. It shows daily windows every day from April 10 to April 12 starting at 7 a.m. Central Daylight Saving Time. I plotted the area in yellow along with the marine closures. If I had to guess, I think the launch date will slip. That is just me weighing all of the evidence out there, reports from reputable reporters, and the things that still need to happen. But, I would not bet a house on Monday not happening. It is also classic SpaceX for the schedule to push out several days, and then for someone to push hard to reel it back in. Hazard zones going down will likely be the best sign, if early next week really gets ruled out. Yes, that is another piece of evidence in favor of it still being on the table, although I would not put too much weight into it. Could just mean that the FAA has not been informed yet. If it is still up tomorrow morning, that will mean more, I think. The FAA has not made a license determination for the SpaceX Starship Super Heavy operation, and the FAA's command center planning notice should not be interpreted as an indicator that a determination to issue a license has been made or is forthcoming, the FAA said in a statement. SpaceX's launch license for the Starship test could be granted by the FAA on Monday, according to a person familiar with the process who asked not to be named. They cautioned that the licensing process, while nearing completion, could take longer due to an environmental compliance review. The test mission will mark the first launch of SpaceX's fully stacked, 394-foot, 120-meter tall Starship rocket system, consisting of a Starship rocket sitting atop a Super Heavy first-stage booster with 33 rocket engines. SpaceX stacked Ship 24, and CEO Elon Musk noted that the company was proceeding very carefully to avoid an explosion that could set Starship progress back by approximately 6 months. Musk has indicated that those upgrades might involve fortifying Super Heavy Booster 7's thrust section to ensure it can survive Raptor engine failures. With 33 Raptor V2 engines powering it and plenty of evidence that those Raptors are far from perfect reliability, the concern is understandable, even if the response is a bit different than SpaceX's norm. Prior to the start of preparations for Starship's orbital launch debut, SpaceX sped through Starship development like it wanted to destroy as many rockets as possible, which, to some extent, it did. Rather than spend 6 to 12 months fiddling with the same few prototypes without a single launch attempt, SpaceX churned out Starships and test articles and aggressively tested them. A few times, SpaceX pushed a little too hard and made avoidable mistakes, but most of the failures produced large amounts of data that was then used to improve future vehicles. The holy grail of that project was high-altitude Starship flight testing, which saw SpaceX finish, test, and launch a new Starship 5 times in 6 months, and culminated in the first fully successful high-altitude Starship launch and landing in May 2021. SpaceX could begin the next phases of Booster 7 and Ship 24 testing as early as April 10, before first orbital launch as soon as April 11 and 12. Even in its more cautious third phase, Starship development is still extraordinarily hardware-rich, moving quickly, and uncovering many problems on the ground in lieu of learning from flight tests. But that doesn't change the fact that the third phase of Starship development 2021 today is proceeding more carefully than the first. Nonetheless, SpaceX appears to finally be getting closer to Starship's first orbital launch. According to SpaceX, the company could be ready for the first launch attempt as early as next week, but an April 17 attempt is highly likely. He believes that SpaceX will have two pairs of orbital-class Starships and Super Heavy boosters, B-7 and S-24, B-8 and S-25. ready for orbital flight by then, potentially enabling a rapid return to flight after the first attempt. Musk is also excited about Super Heavy Booster 9, which has many design changes, and a thrust section that will fully isolate all 33 Raptors from each other, crucial for preventing the failure of one engine from damaging others. The FAA released a draft programmatic environmental assessment, or PE, in September 2021, outlining SpaceX's updated plans for the area. The document revealed that during the ongoing development of Starship, SpaceX plans to conduct up to 20 sub-orbital launches of Starship per year. The company also plans to conduct up to 5 orbital, or sub-orbital launches with Starship per year. Sending the vehicle to high altitudes, or into space but not into orbit before attempting to land it back on Earth. During these launches, the Super Heavy booster would attempt to land back on Earth. Either at a landing pad or a platform in the nearby Gulf of Mexico. On top of the massive rocket that SpaceX is also developing to give Starship the extra thrust it needs to achieve orbit. Finally, SpaceX estimated that it would need to close access to the state highway for 500 hours per year for normal operations. And an additional 300 hours per year for anomalies, and things would undoubtedly change as SpaceX progressed in its development. SpaceX predicted that the number of orbital launches would increase over time, while sub-orbital flights would decline after the disruption. Other major additions to SpaceX's plans include the development of a natural gas pre-treatment system to purify methane for use in the Starship rocket, as well as the construction of a pipeline to transport gas to the plant. According to the FAA's decision released today, SpaceX has since scrapped its plans for a natural gas pre-treatment system, a power plant, and a desalination plant. The company has also modified the capabilities of its Raptor engine, which is used to propel Starship as a result of these changes. As part of its environmental review, the FAA held a comments period for SpaceX's proposed plans, which drew both intense criticism and support from members of the public. Many critics demanded that the FAA conduct a new ICE, as the one conducted in 2014 was no longer adequate, based on SpaceX's proposed plans. SpaceX Starship safe landing with the ultimate goal of building a reusable rocket, the concept didn't work out sooner. Failed, the company introduces a second Musk and names it SN1, or serial number 1, in the hope that others will build and test the machine as soon as possible. SpaceX engineers learned what worked and what didn't and, as Elon Musk put it, quickly passed it on to the next version of SpaceX. Failure was a necessary step as we headed to S24, for the Starship maiden 25 orbiter HIP to connect the engine to another. Ring testing phase. Found parts for S27, 28, 29 and even S30. SpaceX is trying to build cheap mass-produced vehicles first and foremost, so damage of any kind is really far away.